Hi and welcome into this video. In this video I'll show you a free command line tool that can help you recovering your data from an accidentally erased external hard disk or SSD. So this tool comes without any warranty of succeed, so in my case it worked, it just works. But anyway, it's a free tool and it's worth a try. But now let's start. So first of all, you will need the download link of the tool. So the link will be available into the video description. So once you are into the download page of the tool, skip the beta release because for the purpose of the tool and of the video, I think that it's better a stable release in order to have a higher success rate. So for macOS Catalina and newer, you need to install Homebrew. So you will have the link for the Homebrew homepage into the video description. So once you are into the Homebrew homepage, just copy the command you will see with a click to the clipboard near the command. You can copy the command. Now open Terminal. You can quickly open Terminal by using Spotlight. So for Spotlight, hit Command and Spacebar buttons together and then type Terminal and hit the Enter button. So once you are into the Terminal, just paste the command for Homebrew you copied from the homepage of the Homebrew. But yeah. So paste it and then hit the Enter button. Now you need to insert your user account's password. So yeah, in Terminal, when you type a password, you will not see the password. So it will look like you aren't typing, but yeah, you are typing your password. So just type it like normally and then hit the Enter button. Now, when requested by Terminal, by Homebrew in the Terminal, hit another time the Enter button and then let the download and the installation of Homebrew to complete. Once the download and the installation of Homebrew has completed, just type brew install test disk. You can see how to type it by the video, but anyway, you can also see the command into the macOS 64-bit section into the test disk download page. Yeah. Just type brew install test disk and then hit the Enter button. Just wait for the tool to be downloaded and the tool will be downloaded into the path, the destination user, not users, but user slash local slash seller. You can see the path, the destination where the tool was downloaded into the last string of the brew install test drive command. So just select it, copy it with command and C, and then type cd leave a space and then hit command and V in order to paste the path, the destination. And then hit the Enter button. Now you are into the folder of the test drive. You need now to open the bin folder. So type cd, leave a space, and then type bin and hit the Enter button. Now type ls without space, so ls as you see in the video, and then hit the Enter button. This way you can see the content of the bin folder. This folder has the binaries of test disk, which is the and the photorec. Photorec is the one we need, is a part of the test disk tool. So select photorec, hit command and C to the keyboard to copy it, and then type sudo in order to give the tool access to external hard disk or SSD, or also to internal if there are other partitions or volumes. But anyway, I haven't tested it with internal partitions or volumes. But anyway, sudo leave a space and then photorec. You can simply paste it if you have copied, or you can type it, photorec, and then hit the Enter button. Now the tool will open. If you opened the tool before to plug the external hard disk or SSD, you need to quit to close the tool and to reopen it. This way you can see the external hard disk or SSD you have plugged. Now that I have to reopen the tool, I show you another way to open it. You can simply copy the path the destination web test disk was downloaded and then paste it into GoTo folder. You can quickly reach GoTo folder with the keyboard shortcut Command Shift and G. Now you are into the test disk folder and then open a new terminal window. Type cd leave a space and then drag and drop the bin folder from the test disk folder into the terminal window. Now just hit the enter button and now type sudo leave a space and then photorec. Hit the enter button and the tool will open. You can also add the test disk folder into your finder's sidebar, so it is easy and quick to reach it. So now just select the external hard disk or SSD you want to recover and then hit the enter button. Now choose the data partition you want to recover and then hit the enter button and now choose the file system. So for macOS Extended Journaled and for Apple File System you need to select the last option, so the second option, and then hit the enter button. Now you can choose where you want the data to be recovered. By default, it will be recovered into the bin folder, but you can choose, like I chose, to recover it into the pictures folder of my user's account. You can navigate between the folders by using your keyboard's arrow keys. And then when you have chosen where you want for the data to be recovered, just hit the C button on your keyboard. Now just let the tool do his work and yeah. Okay, so this was only an example, which I will quit now because, yeah. And now I will show you what it recovered the first time I used it. Okay, I will not show you everything it recovered, but as you see, it recovered videos, photos, images, but also audio files and text edit files, PDF files, playlist files, and not only. But anyway, if it won't work, if it won't recover every file, just remember that it is a free tool which comes without any warranty of succeed. So yeah, it's anyway worth a try. And then for macOS Mojave down to OS X El Capitan, you can just follow the way I just shown you, because why not use the 64-bit version of the tool if Homebrew is still supported? I can't test right now on OS X Yosemite because I don't have OS X Yosemite installed at the moment on any of my supported Intel Mac computers, but I tested on OS X Mavericks and Homebrew is not supported anymore. So you can just download the test disk folder by clicking macOS X Intel into the test disk download page. So once you have downloaded the folder, just open the terminal and then into the terminal window type cd leave a space and then drag and drop the folder you just downloaded. So now just type sudo leave a space and then type ./photorec. Voila, the tool will open. Okay, so now we will see the one for Windows, which is quite a bit more simple. So go to the download page of test disk. Let's skip the beta release and jump to the last stable release. Click on Windows 64-bit or click on Windows if you have Windows 32-bit. So once you have downloaded the zip file, open it and then drag and drop the folder, the test disk folder, where you want. I choose the desktop. Okay, so now just open the folder and search for the file photorec_win.exe and open it. Voila, the tool will open. Now just select the disk you want the data to be recovered from. Vabbè, yeah. So I will choose this only as an example. Then choose the partition. Now for this example, I choose MS Data. Now for the file system, even for FAT and NTFS, select the second option, so other. Now I choose wall, yeah. Now choose where you want the data to be recovered. So I will choose, yes, it's only an example, so here is okay, C button, and voila, let the tool do his work. So this video ends here. If you liked or if this video was useful to you, hit the like button. If you want, subscribe to the channel and share it if you want.